Yeah, so I'm here from All About The Rock with Barry Tomorrow. Nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you.
So, if I should introduce yourselves.
I'm David and I play bass.
And I'm Danny and I'm the frontman.
Sweet. So, hailing from Portsmouth, Southampton area.
Yeah.
How did it all begin?
Well, basically, it began, there was a local band called Barry Tomorrow, and they kind of started off doing covers and started writing songs, and gradually, I joined because I wanted to play in a band. I just left my band, and then I got Danny involved. We lost the singer, we lost the guitarist, and we kind of we're still kind of just, you know, playing local gigs, that sort of thing. And then one day we started wanting to do it as a proper job, yeah. And we just started doing it properly. And
it's not a better job, by the way.
No, it's fun.
What's the metal scene like down that way, anyway?
It's great. Really good to us. I don't think we would have been as successful as we are right now if it wasn't for the Southampton scene. They systematically made us feel like we were just like a well-known touring act right away from the beginning. We worked hard, we got our friends to come, and then they bring their friends, who would then become our fans. And so eventually we noticed that there wasn't any of our friends there anymore, and we were selling out venues.
Fantastic for sharing that with us anyway. So the name Barry Tomorrow, what made you stick with that name? Where did it come from?
It comes from a phrase, live for today, Barry Tomorrow. It's about just really seizing the day, you've got to take each opportunity you get and just forget about tomorrow. It's all about today. That's where it comes from. We thought it a bit, and Barry Tomorrow is, you know, it's one of those names that you can kind of associate with metalcore and metal. We stuck with that.
Fantastic, man. So your latest upcoming release, The Union of Crowns.
Yeah.
So what were you listening to around the time of writing it and recording it? What were your influences?
Well, to be fair, we always listen to a lot of different stuff. I mean, we've discussed this earlier today. Obviously, you've got your metalcore stuff, you know, your stuff like Parkway Drive, you know, the hardcore stuff like Bury Your Dead, and Bury Your Dead, Evergreen Terrace, that sort of thing. But then also, the rhythms of our breakdowns are inspired by stuff from drum and bass and dubstep. Yeah. Each of those things all help to...
Well, there's a big scene coming up with that, isn't it? Your metal, drum-based dubstep. So is that something you guys might follow into?
It's not something that we do live, but we are definitely influenced by that type of music. Yeah. It's just, we're not going to start putting trance beats and dubstep.
We've all been about a very traditional, since we started, a very traditional metal front and five members, We don't like having anything in the background. We have sub drops and stuff, but, anything that just adds a bit more intensity live. A lot of our friends' bands do it, I don't doubt them for doing that. That's a great thing. Do you want to do that? Kill it, man.
There's something coming out. So many bands are doing it. I mean, Korn started off as well. They have their release and their music apparently doing the next release as well.
It's one of those things. I can appreciate why bands would want to do it.
So cross-referencing here, but what can we expect for the back end of 2012? Obviously, some more gigs lined up and stuff.
We're completing the festival run. Obviously, we've got a lot of festivals to play, which we're excited about. The album comes out, which is going to be badass, the staple point of really our career so far, is getting the second one out. And then we're doing the Architects Tour, which should be absolutely mind-blowing, I'm sure. It's going to be great, very excited for it. And then a couple more tours, just touring.
If you're ever in Manchester, we'll be there anyway.
Well, we're playing Summer Jam in a couple of weeks. We're headlining Summer Jam Festival at the Moto.
We're in Moto, so we'll be there, definitely.
Yeah, it's going to be
awesome. Fantastic. So, finally, last question. Our cousin Sammy here, she's a huge fan, and with her band currently, they're covering one of your songs, Blindheart.
Oh, awesome, right?
So, what advice could you give, if any?
Don't mess it up. Don't mess it up, because if you mess it up, I'll come find you. And then, we'll have the talk, and I'll be like, look, if you're going to cover the song, you need to do it, so you're not messing it up. No, but just keep playing. Just keep playing.
Have fun.
Because we have fun when we play it.
So even though it looks like we're miserable, we have fun.
It's just taken it's been a long weekend, hasn't it? It's very much appreciated. It's been an absolute pleasure to meet you guys.
Pleasure to meet you.
So looking forward to the show as well.
Thank you.
Enjoy doing the cover.
So we're looking forward to the show as well, man.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Another handshake just for clarification.
See you soon, all right.
Have a good day.